Dude, we are all trying to score goals in life. And there's a lot of philosophies, there's a lot of approaches, and you've probably heard of The Secret, right? 30 million copies sold in 50 different languages. And what's the bottom line message? Sit down, do some kumbaya, and think good thoughts, and then a pile of money will drop out of the sky into your lap. Bullcrap. That doesn't produce success for nobody. And if the law of attraction in and of itself is not working for you, today I want to explore why it's not working and what you need to add if you actually want to make killer headway and start scoring goals in your life. Won't you follow me into the jungle? So I've got a belief that really pisses people off. I believe that you can have it all. I'm talking about like the body that is like strong and fit. I'm talking about like the wealth and the house and the ability to travel around the world. I'm talking about like whatever you want. If you apply yourself the right way, if you get the right mentors, if you get the right training, and if you execute, you can have it all. But that goes maybe a little bit contradictory to this whole idea of the law of attraction, right? Kicked off so powerfully in this idea from The Secret when it came out. I remember when it came out, and I remember what it did for me. And there's a lot of complaints out there. It's like, man, it's weird. Like, I got out there, I was sitting on my butt, I was thinking good thoughts, and then good things didn't happen to me. What went wrong? What is this whole law of attraction thing? So this movie comes out called The Secret, and here's a quote. It says, "The law of attraction is a law in nature. It's impersonal. It doesn't see good things. It doesn't see bad things. It's merely receiving your thoughts and then reflecting them back to you through those thoughts as your life experience. The law of attraction simply gives you whatever it is you are thinking about." In other words, imagine that you're a magnet. Rather, your thoughts are a magnet.
Yeah, bitch! Magnets! Oh!
And whatever you're thinking about, those things out here are, like a magnet, are gonna be attracted and they're gonna come into your life. So if you're practicing thinking a lot of bad, nasty, negative thoughts, then bad, nasty, negative things are gonna come into your life. It's also supporting this idea, however, that if you become aware of this law and you start thinking really good, positive, powerful thoughts, that you're gonna attract positive elements into your life. And you can specifically direct it. You could direct it to the conversation of money. Like, you could be thinking about bills, and all of a sudden, what are you gonna see more of? What are you gonna perceive more of? What are you gonna attract more of? You're gonna attract more bills. But it also suggested this idea that you could think about the money that you want that you clearly don't have, and if you just sit and start thinking those positive thoughts, certain amounts of money, that you'll start attracting ideas and opportunities in your life that can make that more possible. Listen, is that just like full of it, or is there something really to it? I was in my early 20s and someone had given me this DVD and said, dude, you have to watch this. And I was curious by nature, so I popped it in and I started watching this movie, The Secret. And it was really intriguing. It was introducing a lot of new ideas to me. And I remember when I got to the end of the video, I was thinking, man, I don't know if this is just full of it. I gotta test this on something. And it was actually good timing because at that point in my life, I was playing every week with my brother-in-law, racquetball. And at first, you know, we were really evenly matched, but over the last 3 months, we would play 3 games every week and he would beat me now every 3 games. And I'd get pissed. I was getting frustrated. I'm like, this sucks. So I just finished the movie and I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna show up 30 minutes early on the court and I'm just going to literally meditate on making perfect shots, perfect serves, that I'm fast, I'm competitive, I read where the ball is going, that I've got strategy in my mind, and that I'm going to dominate and win. My brother-in-law shows up, I had just finished practicing on the court, and you know, he's on like this crazy like streak of win after win after win. We start playing the game and something very different happens. I cream him on the first point, I cream him on the second point, we end up, I literally flush all the way to the end, and I don't let him score a single point. And I win, and I'm like, holy crap, what just happened? This is a total fluke, right? So we decided to play another game. Guess what? I didn't beat him 21-0, but I beat him almost just as bad. And that day I won all three games. He was like, am I having an off day? He was pissed. He was angry. He's like, what happened? I wasn't gonna tell him the secret. For the next couple of months, I kept dominating. I kept beating him. And after a few months, I actually felt bad because I felt like I had this unfair advantage. I remember when I gave him the movie and said, hey, if you really wanna know how I've been beating you, watch this. After he watched it, we played again, and then we were locking horns, evenly matched, and it became more a battle of the mind than a battle of physical ability on the court. The law of attraction for me, hands down, is a principle in becoming successful. But I gotta tell you, thoughts alone are not gonna save you. Thoughts alone aren't gonna make it all happen. You have to follow it up by getting off your butt and actually making things happen. In fact, execution is actually where you start demanding and getting the results. So I became curious, and along the way, I started asking myself, what are other important laws in nature, like the law of attraction, that actually makes it possible to not just have a good shot at success, but guarantee it? If the law of attraction has not worked for you, I want to share with you right now why. It's because wanting one thing, but in your head, having worshiped other thoughts and ideas that directly go against it, will actually shut down attraction from creating that magnetic pull to getting you what you want. Why? Dude, because by the time we exited childhood, we were rehearsing all sorts of other thoughts and ideas that I call limiting beliefs. And these go against the law of attraction because remember, the law of attraction basically says good or bad, you get what you think about. And guess what? If you got a lot of bull crap up here, it's gonna attract more of that crap into your life. I've actually pulled together over the years the top ideas that most of us pick up in childhood that screw us over. And this is the top 30 right now. These are what I call limiting beliefs, like I'm not good enough or I can't do it. You heard the word can't 50,000 times by the time you turn 16 years old. I'm not worthy, I'm too old, I'm too young, my body can't do it, nobody loves me, no one will help me, I don't know how. These ideas are our core operating system that we're using for operating our life. So while you might be trying to live the law of attraction and say, okay, I'm just gonna sit and meditate on good stuff, that's a plus one. But this is the minus one. And one minus one equals zero.
It's a zero multiplied by zero when you get a zero.
Which means you're gonna come up short and you're gonna fall flat on your face. So we need more than just the law of attraction. What I wanna do right now is actually give you a really visual example of exactly what I mean. Check it out. I love it when really nice car companies come out with their really cool concept cars. But you know what? They never make it to market. BMW changed that a few years ago when the i8 came out. And I got on this waiting list and I was so excited for the day that I was gonna be able to buy one of these sexy beasts. The problem is that every time I called in, they said, you're not gonna get your hands on one. No one can get their hands on one. The waiting list is so long. 2 years had passed and I remember waking up this one morning with just this feeling inside that said, you gotta head over to BMW. So I got in the car, I drove on over, and guess what just landed at 6 a.m. that morning in the showroom? A BMW i8, and it was available. They were about to hit the list. They were gonna call, they were gonna sell it to someone. That night when I drove it off the lot, I was like, how did this happen? Well, I knew what I wanted. I spent time thinking and feeling all the good thoughts of what it would be like to actually own this vehicle, and then it came to me. There was like a synchronicity when everything lined up. And I know you've had that experience before. You're thinking about someone and all of a sudden they're calling you. How do you actually get the universe on your side so that you experience synchronicity to get the things in life that you want? What is the only animal on the planet that doesn't have wings but can still fly?
Who's that Pokemon?
People! And there are two kinds of people in the world. Those that believe in gravity and those that don't. We're all subject to the law of gravity. However, there are two ways that you can choose to react to the law of gravity. The first one is you can choose to fall or you can choose to fly. You see, it's not the law itself that limits us. It's our belief system about that law. The Wright brothers, they didn't believe that they had to be held back because there was a law of gravity. When they learned how to fly, they discovered a new law, a higher law, the law of lift, which overcomes the law of gravity. So you get to choose who you want to be. You can either let it be, or you can imagine all the possibilities. It's simply not enough to engage the law of attraction by having good positive thoughts. Earl Nightingale was known for saying, "We get what we think about most." But you know what? It's not just thinking, it's acting. Will Durant takes it a step further. He says, "We are what we repeatedly do." Excellence then is not an act, it's a habit. So in other words, we've got to combine thinking the right thoughts with the right actions that become the habits that we consistently execute on. That is how you create success. I would say that positive thinking is step one. Thinking and knowing what you want is step one. Step two, there's got to be action. You have to execute. And in business, that's how I make money. That's how I roll. That's how I make things happen. James Clear builds on this idea from Will Durant. He says, the word identity, if you think about you and I as human beings and how we craft the thought of who we are as humans, he says, the word identity was originally derived from Latin words, essentius, which means being, and identitum, which means repeatedly. So your identity is literally your repeated beingness. So if the law of attraction has not been working for you, try this on. Every choice that you're making in life is like casting a vote for who you want to become. Look at all the things you can vote for in life. You could put in regular votes for being a good student and getting good grades. And if you were to keep doing that, who are you going to become? Or for example, you eat healthy, you go exercise, you jog and you run. If you cast that vote every day over and over and over again, it creates a trajectory for the future of your life. But similarly, check this out. Let's just say that I start doing the fast food thing, not just once a week or once a month. If I start doing that every day, who am I becoming with all of those votes that I'm casting in my personal ballot box of life? Or if I get into drugs or other addictions, I start Netflix binging once, and before I know it, it becomes a habit and it starts becoming who I am, my identity. Now, if I smoke once, that doesn't make me a smoker. If I go running once, that doesn't make me a runner. Those are things I would have to repeat and do over and over again consistently to become that person, which is, I think, good news, because guess what? We're not perfect. I'm not perfect. We screw up, or maybe we make a mistake. The question is, are you outvoting your mistakes with a lot of good repeated choices? And ultimately, it means this. So as you take control of your identity, be aware that you're also setting your own limits. My research on these 30 top limiting beliefs, you get to choose whether you reinforce these. If you're casting a vote for, I can't do it, and the next opportunity, I can't do that, and the next opportunity, I can't do that, you've created a foregone conclusion that whatever you want in your future, you have a high aptitude of saying can't, because you've built that into your identity by casting that vote over and over and over again. How you correct that is by casting different votes. So what then is the building blocks of our identity? It's not just choice, it's language. The words that we use every single day are going to determine outcome and ultimately destiny in life, especially if we cast that vote over and over and over again. For example, have you ever used the excuse, I'm too old? And then you try something else. Oh, I'm too old for that. Oh, I'm too old for that. That language, casting that vote over and over again, is going to give you an easy out at many opportunities in life versus trying on some different language, like, I have all the time I need to fulfill my goals. This language opens doors of possibility. Here's some other ideas instead of I'm too old. Cast a different vote, like I pivot when the situation calls for it, or I persist with wisdom, or I offer a unique perspective. Those are ways to actually leverage your age as a tool for opportunity and for actually making better choices in life. Now, there are many of you that are actually subscribers to this channel, but I look at the comments and you're constantly hitting up this idea of, oh, I'm too young and I can't do this. And this idea of I'm too young, guess what it means? It means that you have an out from not taking a step forward in life instead of an idea, for example, like I use my youthful energy to fulfill my dreams. Now you've just turned it into a weapon that you can use to move forward and get what you want in life. Instead of my body can't do that, I could run with my body is an amazing gift. Or instead of, I can't afford it, by the way. If you ever say, I can't afford it, I will find you. I will hunt you down.
I will find you. And I will kill you.
This is bad news bears. This is like on a scale of 1 to 10. This is a bad thing to say, especially if you want to be a millionaire, especially if you want to be successful in life. You can't afford this thought. Instead, you should be saying something like, I have the resources for all of my needs and wants, or I attract my resources, or I know how to go out and find the resources so that I'm always moving forward with my life. To me, words are everything. And if you and I spend some time together, you come out to one of my events or you subscribe to my channel and you watch more of my videos, you're gonna see a habit. And the habit is, Chris really doesn't speak from a space of limiting belief. That is from years of practice of realizing that if I speak negativity into my life, I'm casting votes for what I don't want, which especially means that when it hits the fan and life is not going the way you want, you face struggle, you face challenge, in that moment, you intentionally harvest the language and cast votes for what you do want instead of what everyone else does in getting what they don't want. I made today's video in response to some of the comments that I've seen floating around out there where people aren't getting what they want and yet they don't understand why. I hope today brought more clarity. Truth is, there's a lot more information that I have to share with you that can help you get more of the life that you want. This whole channel is about awakening your financial genius, but more importantly, empowering you with the tools to live your ideal life. If you're not a subscriber, make sure you fix that right now because I got more videos coming to you all the time, but more importantly, if you click the link below, I want to give you, I believe, probably the coolest gift that I can give you. I wrote a book, a best-selling book called Limitless. And this book articulates not just what I talked about today, it articulates the rest of the action steps for manifesting the life of your dreams. And so I'm giving that book to you today for free. If you click the link below, my team will go ahead and technically this is my daughter who will ship it up, send it out to you so that I can power you with the knowledge that has empowered me to live my best life. Hey, thanks for hanging with me on today's video. Make sure you give it a thumbs up. If you like today's video and you're like, okay, Chris, mindset is foundational, it comes first. Now I wanna put it into practice and make more money. You should check out two of my buddies from YouTube in this video right here and how in less than 30 days, they quit their jobs and started making enough money to live life on their own.